I'm Adrian Dickson. Vanity Fair director Mira Nair returns with The Namesake, the story of American-born Gogol, the son of Indian immigrants who wants to fit in among his fellow New Yorkers, despite his family's unwillingness to let go of their traditional ways.
I've been thinking a lot about my name. Gogol's fine on my high school diploma, but can you mention Gogol on a resume or a credit card after that?
What are you trying to say?
I'd like to change my name back to my good name.
What is done is done. Now Gogol has become your good name.
It's too complicated now. You're too old.
And anyway, you have only yourself to blame.
Oh yeah, it's my fault because I was 4 years old.
That's right, Gogol.
Anything is possible in America. Do as you wish.
Gogol, played by Kal Penn, born in the US from two immigrant parents, has assimilated the culture given to him. His father, Ashoki, the brilliant Irfan Khan, doesn't mind his son's American disposition so much, but he can't comprehend the levity he shows towards the erstwhile traditions of his ancestors. It's the unexpected death of a family member that brings Gogol, named after a Russian eccentric, back to his ancestral heritage. It also perpetuates his growing displeasure with his white girlfriend, Maxine, played by the ever-reliable Jacinda Barrett, for whom his mother, Ashima, the radiant taboo, appropriately feigns acceptance.
Hi. Ma, this is Maxine. Max, this is my mother.
Hello, Ashima. It's so nice to finally meet you. These are for you and Ashok.
Oh, there was no need. Thank you. Please come in.
Come, thank you.
Please sit. I will get drinks.
It's nice. It's where you grew up, huh?
Yeah.
Gogol's character is one of those great lost souls, unable to separate his identity from his current state of existence, but never happy with being pointed one way or another. Helmer Nair forgoes portrait detailing to turn his life into an intricate landscape of ideologies and beliefs, being ever so careful to never step on a soapbox or raise her voice above a lilting coo. Though tonally rocky after the first hour, Kal Penn's restrained central performance allows for a distinct concentration on mood that elevates the film above Nair's past entertainments. Here, the director has found her most apt presentation of the American way, its blemishes and beauty marks completely intact.